All right, opening day is less than 2 weeks away. Time once again for my season predictions. I did one of these videos last year. You can find that in the upper right corner of your screen. Some of you liked my picks, others not so much. If you disagree with my predictions, tell me why, leaving an extra polite comment just like you did last year. Let's start with the AL East. Here I'm picking the Yankees to win the division, just like I did last year and the year before. Last year they finished second, 7 games out of first. The difference this year will be that Judge and Stanton remain healthy for most of the season, and Severino comes back for the second half. Their bad luck with injuries has got to run out at some point, and I'm predicting that this is the year everything goes right for them. I do not, by the way, think Judge or Stanton will come close to their 2017 numbers, but maybe 30 home runs each. Second place, I'm going with the Rays. They were the best team in the American League last year. During the offseason, they lost Snell and Morton, which is why they won't be the best this year. I won't drop them any further than second because this team always finds a way to remain competitive. They've still got a good lineup, and Austin Meadows is one of those players that had a fluke bad season in 2020. He'll be back to his 2019 form this year. The Blue Jays are a talented young team that is only going to get better. 4 games over .500 a year ago, 7th best in the American League. They'll be even better this year, but not quite enough to catch the Rays. Springer joins the team, and Guerrero will continue to get better, so the offense will improve. But I don't think Ryu is going to be a Cy Young candidate again. And their pitching overall is just not enough. 4th place, Red Sox, up from 5th a year ago. The return of Eduardo Rodriguez and later Chris Sale to the rotation will be enough to get them out of the cellar, but not nearly enough to make them a contender again. Last, as usual, the Baltimore Orioles. There are some reasons to be optimistic about the team's future, but nothing that will make a difference this season. Over to the AL Central. In 2020, it was an exciting 3-team race that wasn't decided till the very end. Expect the same thing this year, but with only 2 teams involved. First place, I'm picking the White Sox. They were 1 game away from winning the division last year, and they made the best offseason additions. Signing Lynn, Hendricks, and Eaton makes this team better. Add to that the continued development of the younger players on a team that finished 10 games over .500 and almost won the Central last year. This team could win 100 games this year. For second place, it's the Twins. They won the Central last year, and they bring the same team back this year. They didn't get worse during the offseason, but they didn't make the kind of improvements we saw from the White Sox. Their hitting is great, but pitching is questionable. I don't think Maeda will be able to duplicate last year's performance, not in a full season. Still a reliable starter, but last year was the best we'll ever see from him. I also don't expect 40-year-old Nelson Cruz to keep hitting the way he did a year ago, but the Twins have enough weapons on offense to make up for it. Third place, Cleveland Indians, the 3rd team involved in that race at the top of the Central. I felt like they were the weakest of the three, and if the season had gone for a full 162 games, they wouldn't have finished so close to the top. Just a feeling, of course, nothing I can prove. But if my feeling was right, and then you take Lindor away, you're left with a very average team that won't be competing for a division title. But strong pitching, led by Shane Bieber, will ensure that they still have a winning record. The Royals will be an improved team offensively with the additions of Benintendi and Santana. That'll help them win a few more games, but pitching was and will continue to be the problem. Last, the Tigers. This will be the best last place team in MLB, and an exciting one to watch with all the young pitchers coming up. But they're still too young to make a big impact. One more year at the bottom for the Tigers, then they start moving up. Next, the AL West. Last year I picked the A's to win this division. I was right. I said the Astros would struggle. I was right. I said they would finish 4th. I was wrong. The rest of the division was weaker than I had expected. Again, I'm picking the A's to win the division. It seems like everyone is picking them to finish 2nd or even 3rd. But the A's, much like the Rays, find a way to stay competitive, even when they lose some of their best players. And losing Hendricks is not a big deal since they picked up Trevor Rosenthal to replace him. They're bringing back the same quality team that won the division in 2020. That'll be enough to repeat as AL West champions. For 2nd place, I'm picking the Astros, exactly where they finished last year, only this time they'll be over .500 and closer to the top in the standings. Springer is gone, but their hitting is still strong. Altuve will bounce back and hit like he did 2 years ago. But the pitching is not good enough to win the West. Verlander is not coming back. Greinke is on the decline. Bullpen is pretty good, but the rotation needs help. The Angels will be the most improved team in the American League. Hitting is not a problem, never was. Trout and Rendon come back to lead their offense. Pitching has always been their problem. They added Alex Cobb and Jose Quintana to the rotation, which will help, but the improvement will hardly be noticeable. We'll see some kind of rebound from Otani in pitching and or hitting. If he excels on the mound, that'll be great for the team, but not enough to lift them into the postseason. The Mariners were just 2 games behind the Astros for a spot in the postseason. The short season and the weak division allowed the Mariners to overachieve. This year they won't challenge for a postseason spot, but they are better than they were 2 years ago. Marco Gonzalez gets better every year, leading a decent rotation. some good young talent on this team. They're heading in the right direction. But this year they're going to miss the postseason for the 20th straight season. That leaves the Rangers in last. Just not a good team all around. No hope for them this year. Over to the National League, starting with the NL East. Should be a really good race at the top, but I'm predicting no change for the top spot, and I'm picking the Atlanta Braves for a fourth straight NL East title. They had the league's highest scoring offense, led by hitters like Acuna and Freeman, and all the major contributors are back. They won the division by a comfortable margin and almost reached the World Series. Any team in the East that wants to catch the Braves has a lot of catching up to do. That's not to say it's impossible, though. The Mets could have been the second place team a year ago if luck had been on their side. Stroman missed all of the 2020 season. He'll be back in the rotation this year, joining DeGrom, one of the best pitchers in MLB. And they signed Carlos Carrasco, giving him one of the best rotations. Then there's the possibility of Syndergaard returning, making it even stronger. They were a good hitting team last year, leading the league in team batting. Unfortunately, that didn't lead to a lot of scoring. They also grounded into the most double plays and left the most runners on base. But their offense and defense got a big boost with the addition of Lindor. I think this team will be close behind the Braves and grab the second wild card. The Phillies were third a year ago, and I don't see them getting any better or worse, so I'm picking them to finish third again. They've got some big names in their lineup. Harper, Realmuto, McCutcheon, Nola on the mound, so they won't be a bad team with players like that. But I feel like if this team was going to do something big with these players, they would have done it by now. Nationals are my pick for fourth, though they could easily finish third. A lot of big names in their lineup too. Soto and Turner were two of the league's best hitters in 2020, and they added Josh Bell and Kyle Schwarber during the offseason. For pitching, they've got Scherzer, Strasburg, and Corbin. The problem is, I think Scherzer's best days are behind him, and they'll be counting on rebound seasons from Corbin and Strasburg. Corbin had a 4.66 ERA last year. Strasburg missed almost the entire season. The Nationals will do better than their last place finish a year ago, but not good enough to reach the postseason. Marlins are the last place team in the East this year after finishing second a year ago. They were able to take advantage of the rest of the division's bad luck and sneak into the postseason. I don't think that would have happened in a full 162-game schedule, and the other NL East teams will be much stronger this year. Next, the NL Central, probably the weakest division in MLB this year. I'll pick the Cardinals here. They were second last year, three games out of first. Pitching was strong. Wainwright was good, but he's getting up there in age. They'll be hoping he has one more good year left in his arm. Then if Flaherty can bounce back and look like his 2019 self, they'll be all set. Offense was a problem last year, but they helped themselves out by signing Arenado during the offseason. It's not going to make them a World Series contender, but it will push them to the top of the Central. Second place, Milwaukee Brewers. They finished with a losing record because of their hitting, but not too bad because their pitching, especially the bullpen, was really good. The pitching is back and the hitting gets better with the additions of Colton Wong and Jackie Bradley Jr. I don't know if Yelich will be able to hit like he did in 2019, but I'm sure he'll hit better than he did in 2020. Third place, the Cubs, Central Division champions a year ago. Pitching was their strength last year. Darvish was the biggest part of that, and now he's gone. Arrieta is back with the team, but he won't come anywhere near Darvish's numbers from last year. Kyle Hendricks is their ace now. Hitting was weak, but it will be better. Rizzo, Baez, and Bryant will see some kind of rebound, but it won't make up for the departure of a Cy Young candidate. The Reds were over 500 and made the postseason last year behind a strong pitching staff, led by Cy Young winner Trevor Bauer. He is no longer with the team, so the pitching can't possibly be as good. But it'll still be good. Plenty of good starters and relievers. It's the hitting that will keep the team down. Castellanos and Suarez are good hitters, but there's not a good supporting cast around them. The Pirates are looking like they'll be the worst team in MLB. Though, given the weakness of the division, they may not be the losingest. Still, they'll be rock bottom in the Central. And last, the NL West. I have to go with the Dodgers here. They won the World Series, had the best record in all of MLB, National League's best pitching, and second highest scoring offense. The pitching gets even better with the signing of Bauer. No weak link in their rotation, good bullpen, all the good hitters like Mookie Betts and Corey Seager coming back. But that does not mean they'll win the West by a huge margin. The Padres may be the second best team in MLB. Six games behind the Dodgers in 2020, their answer to the Dodgers signing the NL Cy Young winner was to go out and grab the NL Cy Young runner-up and a former AL Cy Young winner in Blake Snell. Already a great hitting team, they added to it by signing Caratini and Kim, as well as keeping Tatis Jr. on a 14-year contract extension. So that doesn't leave a lot of hope for the rest of the division. The Giants look like the third best team in the West. Too many aging players in their lineup. Crawford, Posey, Longoria, Cueto. Brandon Belt looked really good last year, but I don't think he can do it for a full season. The younger players are improving, though. They'll help bring this team up to 500. The Diamondbacks were disappointing last year, and they didn't make any big changes during the winter. I expect rebound seasons from Bumgarner and Marte, so that'll help bring them out of the cellar. But it's still a losing team. The Rockies were already a bad team, and then they lost Arenado. Not good hitting or pitching. Definitely a last place team. So, in the AL, I've got the Yankees, White Sox, and A's winning their divisions. Rays and Twins getting the wild cards. Braves, Cards, and Dodgers win the NL divisions. Mets and Padres get the wild cards. In the American League, it comes down to the Yankees and White Sox. Assuming everything goes right for the Yankees and everyone is healthy going into the postseason, I'll pick them to win. In the NLCS, I'll say Dodgers over Braves, again. But the Padres and Mets both have a really good shot at knocking off the Dodgers. So while I think the Dodgers will have an historically great regular season, I do not think they will just roll through the postseason. But in the World Series, I'm predicting the Dodgers repeat, beating the Yankees in 5. That's what I think. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. That's all for this one, and until next time, this is Baseball International. See ya.